The management at UFO Moviez is now joining us. They declared their numbers earlier. Sir, if you could just first tell us about the numbers. Very, very strong set of quarter. After Q1, there were doubts that Q2 would be strong or not. But a good set of numbers, especially on the ad curve.
Yeah, you know, in the ad, this is the paradox. The ads growth varies very substantially quarter on quarter. Like last year in one quarter it was 88% and in one quarter it was 7%. But we had given the guidance of 35% last year and we achieved 35.3% at the end of the year. So the variations are very large. Like last quarter it was 9.5% and this quarter it is over 50%. But overall annual guidance we have given is 30%, and right now we are at 29.4% for the H1. So I think that because of the release of the movie, the government ads, they vary from quarter to quarter. But overall, I think 30% growth is what we'll be doing. So very strong quarter, and I think overall we'll achieve it.
Right. As far as your earlier, move is concerned, so you were traditionally targeting a lot of advertising dominated by central government. But now is that shifting? Are you looking at the state government and that led to the uptick in the ad numbers?
Actually, when we talk about the government advertising, it consists of three sectors, which is the central government, state government and PSUs. In fact, this quarter even the PSUs have been very strong. Paradox is that, when you talk about government PF, when you talk about a State Bank of India or an LIC or a BSNL, we classify it as a government advertiser. But if you go to ICICI Bank or ICICI Pru, you talk about climate with the private sector. So we have seen good growth in both PSUs and central government. And state government now, we started that like 3 years back. Now almost 16-17 state governments are already on board. But the state government revenue varies very heavily quarter on quarter. Central government is more stable and to that extent.
Right. If you just look at the corporate revenue, it has been flat. What do you think is it led by?
As I said that, we see corporate revenue really depends. One, yes, more and more corporates are coming. In the government, we have to lead our growth by two things. One is the utilization of minutes, second is the pricing. So far as government sector is concerned, pricing is fixed by DAVP, so there is no variation. That pricing is fixed. So in the corporate sector, we also keep testing along with side increasing the number of minute utilization. We also keep testing the pricing. So this year, this quarter, we also tested higher pricing because there was a good lineup of movies release. So to that extent, sometimes the minute utilization may drop, but the overall minute utilization we have seen from 1.66 minutes 4 years back is now up. Last quarter was 5.15 minutes. So we are consistently seeing it, and we need to continue testing the pricing power also.
Right. Can you talk to us about the margins? So in Q1, there was an increase in the revenue but contraction in the margin. What happened in Q2?
Lot depends on the mix of the advertising business, because advertising business is a very high margin business. So in Q1, the share of advertising in the overall revenue mix was only 24%. In Q2, it is 33%. 55% of the advertising revenue straight away goes to our EBITDA margin. So first quarter, while we saw around 24% EBITDA margin, Q2 we suddenly saw 35% EBITDA margin, and that's what brought the overall EBITDA margin back to 31%. So advertising revenue is the highest margin business for us, and that does the trick.
Higher commissionings, selling and distribution expenses, all of that continued in Q2.
If you do higher sale, there will be higher commissions. It is as simple as that. So they are absolutely in line, expenses are absolutely in line with the revenue. It is not that, there is anything out of proportion. So if you see absolute number, Q1 to Q2, there will be more expenses, but then there is more sale also. So obviously there will be more expenses in absolute numbers, but in percentage terms, it is absolutely in line with our sales.
Right. As far as the coming next 6 months are concerned, what do you think will be the growth triggers as people go more and more digital? how will UFO movies benefit?
Well, the cinema industry, the exhibitions is almost 100% digital already. So we are not really seeing any major impact of further digitization into our future. The industry is growing barely by 2 or 3%. So that is the kind of growth we will also see in having further digital screens. Major growth is going to be driven by the uptake in the advertising revenue. As I said that, you know, already from 1.66 minutes we are close to 5 minutes now, and we have a huge revenue potential. We can, I mean, growth potential, because we can go up to like 14-15 minutes annually. And so you can see, if we go to even 10 minutes, how the revenue will go up. So we are really, and we are depending on growth of advertising revenue. That's what we are pushing very hard, as well as our newer businesses and newer initiatives, which are all very high margin initiatives.
And sir, you would be uniquely placed in the digital space because of you know, the sort of reach that you have, the pan India presence that you have.
We are the single largest entity. So, you know, overall digital cinema market or the exhibition market sector, we have 50%, 55% of the digital cinema market by the number of screens. And we are spread over almost 1400 cities, towns and villages. So we have the largest spread, maximum number of screens. The balance 45 screens are divided amongst the other 4 or 5 players. So we are the single largest player, and that brings us the benefit of having the single largest network of advertising screens also. And as you know, in every sector, whether it is print media, whether it is satellite TV or any other sector, the largest player always gets the disproportionate share of revenue and higher pricing. So that's, I think that's what we are benefiting with consistently.
What would be the risk from a large exhibitor like PVR or INOX?
Nothing, they are not. So out of the 5,055 odd screens that we have currently to make up about 55% market share, PVR, INOX, other chains, major chains are around 1,200-1,300 screens. So we don't command the advertising of that, and we have advertising of only around 3,750 screens. So our real main growth is coming from these 3,750 screens, which are non-PVR, non-INOX screens. PVR and INOX are our clients only for digitization, not for the advertising. So all the growth which you see is actually from these 3,750 screens, and that's what we are growing consistently, not really depending on PVR and INOX.
Right. Sir, thank you so much for explaining us about the quarter and what is the way forward for UFO movies.